Let's see how to send information between web pages and also how to query data based on these parameters. What we want to do is to create a screen to display the contact details for each one of the contacts that we have in our phone book application. So let's add a new web screen to our application and we will call it contact detail. Don't forget to set the anonymous role here so that we don't have to handle security. And let me open here the screen. So in this screen, we want to show the details of a contact in our phone book application. And to do this, we need to identify what is the contact that we want to see here. And we will do that by sending information from this contacts list screen into the contact detail page. And to send information from one page to the other, we will need to add an input parameter in the contact detail screen. This input parameter allows a screen to receive data that will help prepare the information to be rendered. In this case, we will use the contact identifier in this input parameter. So let me call this contact ID. And the platform infer that the data type is contact identifier. We will actually use this contact identifier in the preparation to fetch the data from the database. So let's add a preparation to our screen. And to fetch the data, again, we will use an aggregate here. And let me open it up. And we want to fetch a contact. So drag and drop the contact entity here, and these are all the contacts. We actually want to fetch a particular contact. So to do this, we will need to set a filter in our aggregate. To fetch the contact that we want to show, we use the value of the input parameter to get that record from the database. So here we'll add the filter, and we are going to use this input parameter, the contact identifier, to match it to the ID property of the contact entity. So basically what we're saying is that fetch me the contact from the database that has this identifier. And as you can see here, this will return only one contact. Okay, so we're done with preparing the data to render our screen. Let's go back to the screen and let's add a title to the screen. We want to show here the name of the contact. This is information that comes from the database. This is a dynamic page as you've seen before. So we will need to use an expression for this. And let me drop the expression here in the title and fill in the value. And the value for the expression will be the name of the contact from the aggregate that we have on the preparation. Now, we are going to use again the current property because this points to the first element here on this list. And we're going to get the name of that contact that we have on the list. Since we only have one contact in this aggregate, this current will point to that first element and to that contact. Now we're done with the title, and now we need to show the remaining details of the contact. And to do that, we are going to use here this form widget. The form widget allows to display and edit a single record. In this case, we will use it to display the contact fetched from the database. And since this will be a contact, let me drag and drop again the contact entity into the form. Okay, from the red sign here, I know that I still have some errors here in my page before I can publish. One thing that I recall that I did in the contacts screen was that I had to bind the data from the preparation, the data from that came from the database, I had to bind that data to the widget on the screen. So if I select here the form, this widget here, the form, you'll see that we also have here a source records property that we need to fill in with the data that comes from the preparation. So let me double click here, the source record. And this property defines the record with its initial values that the user will edit in the form. In the next lesson, we will see how to edit this data. For now, I just want to display the contact in the form, so I'll need to bind it to the current contact that we fetch from the database. Again, remember that this current property here points to the first contact on that list. And there we have it. Now we're all green, we're all good to go. Let me just publish the application so that we can see it in a browser. I still have one thing missing before we can publish, because I need to be able to navigate into this contact detail page from the contacts page. So let me just quickly go back here into the contacts page, and I want to create a link here on the expression that has the name of the contact. Let me create a link to another destination. I'm going to select here the contact detail page. Now remember, we defined that the contact detail page has an input parameter, so we have an error because we didn't fill in the value for that input parameter. And we are going to fetch that value. We're going to fill in this value with the current property again, in this case of the widget of the table records, and we're going to fill it in with the contact ID, the ID attribute of the contact that is on that current property of the list. We're good to go. Let's publish this in the browser. Okay, so here we have our list of contacts, and now we have a link in the name of the contact. And if we click on this link, you will notice that we'll go into the detail page, and we are looking into Joanna Rivera contact with her phone number. You'll also notice here on the URL of this page, you'll notice that we are sending more information into the server. We are actually getting the contact ID parameter here in the URL. And this ID is going to be used in the preparation to fetch this contact from the database. Then this information is bound to the form that we have here on the screen, and the information is shown to the user. That's it.